Hello, welcome to JC Best Online Tutorial. I am Gracious Abaku. Today, we will be looking at types of cooperative society, the advantages and the disadvantages. In our last class, we were able to look at the meaning of cooperative society and also some features of cooperative society. So today, we will be looking at some of the advantages and the disadvantages. So our specific objectives for today's class are: one, at the end of this class, we should be able to establish or explain consumer cooperative, state the advantages of cooperative society, then state the disadvantages of cooperative society. And the first on our list here is the wholesale cooperative. It is usually formed by small-scale wholesalers who purchase goods in bulk from the manufacturers at a reasonable price and sell in small quantities to retail cooperative or to the retailers. Now, as the case may be, we were able to establish in the last class that cooperative societies, they come together to pool their resources so as to see how they can help members of their society. Now, just like the wholesale cooperative, they also come together to see how they can buy goods in bulk at a cheaper rate or reasonable price and then sell to their retailers. Now, please take note that the benefit here is for the entire member. And then we have the retail cooperative. The retail cooperative, just like the wholesale cooperative, is like the coming together of the retailers in order to buy goods in large quantities. Now, usually they do this so as to buy goods at a cheaper price, either directly from the manufacturer or from the producer. And then we have producer cooperative society. It is a cooperative that is formed by producers of similar products and undertake joint marketing of their products. The cooperative society members may be farmers. Now, such a society of producers, what happened here is that they also come together, they put their resources together either for two purposes, either one, to produce at a cheaper price so as to buy the raw materials that are needed for production, or on the other hand, so as to see how they can sell their products to the market. So producer cooperatives come together just like the wholesaler and the retailer so as to benefit their members. So they put their resources together so they can tap from the advantages that is available when they do things in large scale. Then we have the credits and trades cooperative. Now, usually it is an association of low income earners. It is done so as to encourage members to form the saving habits. You know, some people do not have that discipline, or they cannot discipline themselves enough so as to be able to save. Now, with this, they are able to form the habits to save. And secondly, this is a society that gives out loans, soft loans, to their member at a very reasonable or low interest rate. And such loans do not require collateral. Unlike when you visit the bank for a loan, the bank will definitely require requests for collateral or they will request for guarantor. But in this case, such is not needed. You can access loan from these cooperatives without a guarantor or collateral, provided you are a member of the society or cooperative. And then we have the multipurpose cooperative society. A multipurpose cooperative society is the kind of society that has the characteristics of other cooperatives. Now, usually, when a cooperative has more than one characteristics of a cooperative, take for instance, where we have the consumer, the producer, we know that the producer is a combination or is coming together of producers of similar products. Or in the case of consumer, is the coming together of consumer so as to purchase goods at a cheaper rate. A society or a cooperative society that has more than one of these features can be referred to as a multipurpose cooperative society. And then we'll talk about the consumer cooperative. This is a voluntary association of consumers who put their resources together to buy in bulk directly from either the manufacturer or producer, thus bypassing the wholesaler. Now, you see, one of the reasons the consumer would go directly to buy from the producer is so as to bypass the middlemen. And some of these middlemen, they have some of their activities that do not really go well with the consumer. For instance, they can exploit the consumer with a very high price. So in order to, you know, bypass this, they can approach the producer or manufacturer directly. But this can be achieved when they put their resources together so as to buy at a cheaper price from the producer or from the manufacturer. And then we have the management of cooperative society. The management of cooperative society is usually left in the hands of the members that are elected to manage the cooperatives. Now, the cooperative here, what happens is that they usually, you know, hold, let me say, an election. You know, it is one of the characteristics is that it is democratic in nature. Now, since it is democratic in nature, they definitely would elect members that represents or that will manage the cooperative society. So one of the ways they do that is by electing their members that will manage the cooperative. So the committee is usually made up of 12 members. And let's look at some of the advantages of cooperative society. Though there are a lot of advantages, but in this case, we'll be considering just a very few of them. Now, the first one is that it is a voluntary organization. Now, what it means here is that no one is forced to join the society. So you can join the society willingly without being coerced or being forced by anyone to join. Now, any person with common interest can become a member. So when you become a member, you definitely benefit from being a member. Then ease of formation. It is very easy to form, unlike company. You know, company, they have to go through a lot of legal formalities. But in this case, such do not happen. It becomes very easy as long as the members are willing to, you know, form a cooperative society. Now, democracy, yes, it is democratic in nature. One of the reasons is because it has a principle of one man, one vote, which implies that all members have equal rights in managing the affairs of the enterprise. So here, nobody has that autonomous power to oppress or suppress the members of the cooperative society, in as much as it is democratic in nature. Everyone has equal rights. And then we have equitable distribution of surplus. Now, you know, like I said in the last class, I told us that cooperative society do not exist basically to make profits. Coming together to make profit is not their main objective. Rather, it is to improve the welfare of their member. So they distribute their surplus. Take for instance, they are able to carry out a certain business and then they're able to make some little profits from it. So the surplus, which is the profit, they can be distributed equitably among the members of the corporate society. Hence, they are able to improve or promote the welfare of the member. Now, limited liability. Here, what it means here is that the liability of the member in the corporate society is limited to the extent of their capital contribution. So should the business run into debt? The debts of the business is only limited to the capital that is contributed by each member of the cooperative society. So which is to say that They cannot go beyond, or the business cannot go beyond the capital that was contributed by the member in order to pay for the debts. So they cannot be personally held liable for the debts of the cooperative society. Therefore, it is known as a limited liability entity. Then stable existence. Here it implies that the debts of a member cannot bring an end, you know, the cooperative society. So here there is stable existence. Whatever happened to any member of the society cannot in any way bring the cooperative society to an end. So it has what we call a perpetual existence as part of the characteristics of the cooperative society. And then elimination of middlemen. Now, you know, the middlemen here will basically have to do with the retailer and then the wholesaler. Let's take, for instance, a consumer cooperative. Now, a consumer cooperative can go directly to buy from the producer or the wholesaler. So in this case, they are able to eliminate the activities of the middlemen. So, you know, the middlemen here, like I said, refers to the wholesaler and the retailer. And these guys here, they are bent on making profits. So by the time the consumers go directly to buy from the manufacturer or the producer, they are able to reduce the activities of the middlemen, and therefore they can save a huge amount of money. And then let's look at the disadvantages of cooperative society. Now, first here, we have lack of managerial skills. Now, this could be as a result of inefficiency or inefficient management. Now, you know, some of the people that might be elected or appointed to manage the cooperatives may not have that experience, that business acumen that is needed to manage the cooperative. Hence, it's going to affect the effectiveness or the efficiency of the cooperative society. Two, we have the government intervention. Now, this has to do basically with the regulations that come from government. And as a cooperative, they are bent on adhering to various rules and regulations that come from the government. Therefore, this tends to interfere with their independence. And then we have misuse of funds, corruption, so to say. We have it almost everywhere. In the government, in the private sector, we have it there. Now, some people might be so greedy and then swindle or take advantage of the fund that is available to manage the cooperative. Now, those that were elected to manage the cooperative might just, you know, decide, given the fact that they are the one in charge, they might just decide to embezzle the fund that was supposed to be used to manage the cooperative society. And then inefficiencies leading to losses. Now, when there is inefficiency, of course, it will lead to loss. Let's say there is when the funds are being misappropriated. Now, this can definitely lead to losses. Now, here, what we have here, it says corporate societies operate with limited financial resources. Therefore, they cannot recruit the best talent. Now, when they do not have enough funds, what happened here is that they may not employ those who are capable of managing the cooperatives. So therefore, they will make do with what is available. Just anyone they feel can handle it, even if the person do not have the necessary skills or qualification that is needed to manage the cooperatives. Then we have lack of secrecy. Businesses today thrives with secrets. And how do I mean? Some of these businesses we have around us, they have some secrets that is best known to them that helps them to rise above their competitors. Now, in the case of cooperative society, there is no secret. Now, everything is opened to every member of the society. Now, such information can be leaked or become a public knowledge Therefore, it becomes very difficult for the cooperative society to be effective and efficient. Then we have conflicts among members. Conflict among members. You know, it is very common to have conflicts. People have their differences, given their human nature. They might have what we call ideological differences, political differences, opinion, as the case may be, and such can lead to quarrels or squabble that might, one way or the other, hamper or affect the efficiency of the cooperative society. So if a dispute arises and such dispute is not handled properly or in a mature way, it can definitely affect the cooperative society. Thank you for your attention. So this is where I'm going to stop for today. Now, next class, we'll be looking at some other aspects of cooperative society. So I'll make the material available in the Google Classroom. So please visit the Google Classroom so you can access the materials, the slides that you can see on the screen. They are available in the Google Classroom. So thank you for paying attention. I do hope you enjoyed today's class. Do have a wonderful day. God bless you.